focused on normalized impedance and deflection coefficient. Now, let us assume that we are having a number of parallel transmission lines. If we are having a parallel line, then instead of going for impedance, we should focus on admittance. We are knowing that admittance is 1 by of impedance. So, your Z is equal to 1 by Y. Okay? So, in case of parallel transmission line, we need to go for admittance. And your admittance Y is equal to G plus JB. Okay? Here, G is conductance and this B is susceptance. Okay? So, what we should do that as we have seen normalized impedance, we need to find normalized admittance also. So same, your normalized admittance y bar will be your y by y naught, that is your small g plus jb. And similarly, we can go for your reflection coefficient in terms of your admittance. So reflection coefficient will be here as you are having a z minus z naught, so it will be your 1 by y minus 1 by y naught. And here you are having the z plus z naught, you will be having 1 by y plus 1 by y naught. If you are solving this, you will be getting y naught minus y and y naught plus y. This you will be getting. So, reflection coefficient in terms of admittance, you are getting this one. We can find the reflection coefficient in terms of normalized admittance. In terms of your normalized admittance, it is your 1 minus y bar by 1 plus y bar. Okay, so this you will be having. Now, let us see that we are going for the reflection coefficient L. L means at a distance L from the load. So, from the load side, the distance is L. So, reflection coefficient is this one. So, if you are solving this, we will be having say gamma L. Here we are going for the modulus of that one. E to the power j theta L, e to the power minus j 2bl. Okay? Here we can take j as a common and we are getting this. So, here modulus of gamma L, this one is your magnitude. So, this part is your magnitude in case of the reflection coefficient, and whatever this is there, theta L minus JBL, this will be the angle. Now, as we are knowing the magnitude and we are knowing the angle, we can represent it in the smith chart. So, when we are going for representing it in the smith chart, we are having this complex gamma plane. Here, let us assume that this is the point. So, from the center, whatever this distance is, this distance will be the magnitude, and the angle that it is making, this will be the required angle. So, if somebody is asking about what about the detail of the reflection coefficient, this reflection coefficient is consists of the magnitude component and the angle component. So, this will be the magnitude and this will be the required angle in case of your Smith chart.